Every year, millions of tons of sugar are consumed worldwide. 60 tons of this unique root vegetable are harvested every hour. Razor-sharp blades cut the beets into thin slices. But how exactly is sugar extracted from these beets? In this video, we delve into the process that yields 1.4 million tons of sugar each year. It's been 250 years since the discovery that sugar can be extracted from beets. In 1747, German chemist Andreas Margraf demonstrated that beet sugar is identical to cane sugar. While sugarcane only thrives in tropical climates, this more resilient sugar beet can be cultivated in colder regions and poorer soils. By the early 19th century, beet processing factories had emerged across northern Europe. In Great Britain, over 2 million tons of sugar are consumed each year, and surprisingly, more than half of that amount comes from the beet grown in the UK. Sugar beets start as seeds, nurtured to promote growth, and are sown. 80 days later, the beets mature through photosynthesis, where the leaves absorb sunlight and convert it into chemical energy. Sugar beets are harvested between September and February on approximately 3,500 farms located in the eastern counties. Once they reach optimal size and sugar content, harvesting occurs at facilities such as the one in Norfolk, which processes 3 million tons of this crop annually. Two-thirds of the UK's sugar beets are grown in this region, but extracting them isn't as simple as pulling them from the ground. The sugar is concentrated in the lower part of the roots, so it's crucial to extract them whole. A typical beetroot weighs around 1 kilogram, with 18% of it being sucrose, or sugar. Harvesting sugar beets is a complex operation requiring a massive machine. This mechanical beet harvester combines incredible power with great efficiency, boasting 530 horsepower and equipped with blades that cut the leaves and roots, leaving only the root used for sugar production. Designed for delicate harvesting, this machine handles everything from extraction to cleaning in 6-row increments. Special blades cut the stems to ensure the valuable roots remain intact, while V-shaped steel wheels carefully extract the beets. 13 cleaning rollers spin the beets to remove any dirt residues. It takes approximately 5 beets to produce just over 1 kilogram of sugar. After harvesting, the beets are prepared for processing. They undergo an initial cleaning to remove soil and other attached impurities. The leaves, which do not contain sugar, are removed, and the beets are loaded into harvesters that can gather more than 25 tons per hour. The harvested beets are temporarily stored before being transported to the processing factory. Storage conditions prevent decay and quality loss. British farms produce nearly 7 million tons of beets annually. This crop is essential for producing sugar that sweetens tea, coffee, and desserts. Beets are transported from the field to the processing factory with the aim of minimizing damage to maintain their quality. Trucks carry the beets 45 kilometers from the farm to the sugar factory. The next challenge is processing 9,000 tons of beets daily during the campaign, totaling 1.5 million tons a year. At the factory, the beets are received and weighed. An inspection is carried out to ensure they meet quality standards, and those that are not suitable for processing are discarded. Before juice extraction, the beets undergo a final cleaning to remove any residual dirt. They are unloaded onto a conveyor belt that distributes them to a washing station. Here, the beets float in water and are channeled into the factory. A clever device called a stoner removes any leftover debris by moving the floating beets into a rotating drum. Heavier debris separates, falls to the bottom, and is discarded. However, leaves are still mixed with the beets, and the beets remain too dirty. Therefore, they are sent into another rotating drum that functions like a giant washing machine. Once the beets are clean and ready to be processed into sugar, they are cut into smaller pieces to facilitate juice extraction. Inside a room-sized cutter, razor-sharp blades slice the beets like potato chips. Its 66 rows of blades spin 20 times a minute, producing millions of very thin strips. After cutting, the beets are transformed into V-shaped strips, which provide the largest possible surface area for sugar extraction while maintaining flexibility to prevent them from becoming mushy. These strips travel on a conveyor belt to a large hot water tank, where they soak for a few minutes. This soaking process causes their cell membranes to open, allowing the sucrose to be released during the next step. Cutting the beets into strips makes it easier to extract the sugar, but the sugar won't be released while the slices are cold. To heat them, the strips are transported to giant diffusers. Inside the diffusers, grids fixed to two screws move the beets in one direction, while water at 72 degrees Celsius moves in the opposite direction. Hot water is added to dissolve and extract the soluble sugars. The water temperature is carefully controlled to maximize sugar extraction without degrading its quality. In 90 minutes, almost 90% of the sugar is extracted. The remnants are not wasted. Byproducts of processing, such as molasses and beet pulp, are used as animal feed. The resulting juice, known as liquor, contains sugars, but also impurities like insoluble solids and unwanted compounds. A clarification process is carried out where chemicals are added to coagulate and precipitate the impurities, allowing for more effective separation from the juice. This clear solution contains only 17% sugar, so it's still not sweet enough. Next, it needs to be boiled at 130 degrees Celsius to evaporate the excess water. This concentration process results in a thick syrup with a high sugar content. Most customers prefer sugar in the form of tiny white granules, so the sugar needs to be crystallized for commercialization. To produce large sugar grains, the process begins with microscopic ones. Tiny sugar crystals are added to the syrup, acting as seed nuclei for additional crystal formation. A small amount of these seed crystals is introduced into the concentrated syrup, which is continuously agitated while it cools gradually. This agitation helps distribute the seed crystals and promotes uniform sugar crystal growth. The syrup temperature is carefully controlled during crystallization. As the syrup cools, sugar crystals begin to grow. Constant agitation ensures even growth and prevents excessive clumping. As the crystals grow, the molasses, which is the residual liquid, separates. The crystals are allowed to grow to about 500 to 600 microns, the common size found in supermarkets. After 3.5 hours in the tanks, the crystals are large enough but still covered with sticky syrup. This problem is solved with a few spins in the centrifuge. The sugar crystals, along with the molasses, undergo a centrifugation process. Centrifuges are machines that use centrifugal force to separate components according to their density. In this case, the denser sugar crystals separate from the molasses. The centrifuge spins at 1,100 times per minute, expelling the syrup and separating it from the white sugar crystals. The centrifugal force causes the sugar crystals to stick to the walls of the centrifuge, while the more liquid molasses is expelled and collected separately. This molasses will be used in the production of alcohol and alcoholic beverages. The sugar crystals, still adhering to the centrifuge wall, are then washed with hot water to remove any residual molasses. This washing process improves the sugar's purity and contributes to its final quality. After washing, the sugar crystals are dried to remove any remaining moisture. 60 tons of sugar are extracted from this production line every hour, resulting in the final product of a campaign that produces 1.4 million tons of sugar annually. Finally, the sugar crystals are packaged in bags before being distributed. If you want to know how Doritos are made, watch the video on your screen, and please like the video if you enjoyed it and share it with someone who might be interested. Also, subscribe to this channel by activating the notifications to continue learning. Thanks for watching.